deep conviction and love for Abaco, North Abaco in particular. I want you to stand to your feet, F&Ms. Stand to your feet, North Abaco, as you welcome the next MP for North Abaco, Mr. Greg Gomez.
Someone keeps sending a smile. He wants us to love each other. You see, the more we give, the better we live. Let's help the world of the future.
Wanted to just thank Mr. Ingram. Here's what he thanked him for. In Grand Key, he recalls that he used to have to get up 7:30 in the morning before going to school, run all the way over the hill, catch the boat over to Wells Bay, get water, return back to the island of Grand Key before he can get ready for school. He had to rush and get dressed. His mom would fry pancakes and fried sausage. He would have to grab it, put it in his pocket, and run to school so that he would not be late. Because if he was late, he would get 6 strokes. Well, he said sometimes he would make it on time, and sometimes not. And sometimes he would put his hands into his pocket in class and try and eat his breakfast. Well, you know, after that, his hands were greasy, and he would mess up his papers. And he is proud today to know that the other children in Grand Key have potable water. Those kids don't have to get 6 strokes like how he did, and he's just happy for that. I thank you for sharing with me, North Abaco, some of your ideas for what I can do to push North Abaco even further. I am also proud of our young people who are saying that they are going to stand with me. It is invaluable that they realize that their vote will not be bought. I have to be honest with you and tell you that in the past 3 months, my life has not been easy, nor has it been easy for my family. Since accepting the party's nomination to represent you in North Abaco, I have been viciously attacked day after day. Yes, I am not perfect. I've made some mistakes as a first-time politician. But the attacks on me are far more severe. Are far more severe than what is normal. My family has asked me, is this normal? In some ways, it's normal for you to be attacked. But to go into every nick and cranny of your life, listen, when the tables are turned, Bradley Roberts, be one. But me, my family, and I have made the decision to stay the course. We have made the decision to stand for the righteous cause. We're not going to lose heart. We're not going to let the oppressors win. No, we will stay the course. No matter their lies, we will stay the course. No matter their threats, we will stay the course. No matter how they victimize, no matter how they call me names, no matter how they dehumanize, we will stay the course. We are Abaconians. And Abaconians are not easily scared. And guess what? We are red. And we're just not scared. You see, Mr. Penland, the great Sir Lyndon Penland, came to Abaco in an attempt to defeat the Right Honorable Hubert Alexander Ingram. But what did he get? He was defeated. And guess what? Come October 15th, the PLP will be defeated. defeated. Oh, who you voting? Who you voting? Who you voting? Who you voting for? Since the PLP has been elected, the only thing they have done is confirmed our worst fear. We feared that they, number one, would not be ready to govern under one. And guess what? They're still not ready. We were concerned that they would be victimizers. And guess what? Even up to today, they're still doing it. But guess what? They're not just victimizing. They're doing it openly. They're doing it blatantly. We feared that they would be, that they would only be looking out for their families, their friends, their close insiders, and that is exactly what they're doing. We feared that the old guard would be in charge again, and that's what's happening. Check out the 82-year-old man. North Abaco, Papa has warned us about them, and just as he warned us, so it is. But we do not have to give them any more strength. We do not have to endorse their conduct in government. Let's vote for Greg Gomez and the FNF. A vote for Greg Gomez is a vote for courage. A vote for me is a vote for fairness. A vote for me is a vote for genuine concern for all Abaconians. As your member of parliament, I said as your member of parliament, I will hold the government accountable. I will put fire to their feet. I will sound the alarm when they do what is wrong. I will sound the alarm when they don't do what they should. This means that I will sound the alarm if they do not do what they shouldn't do. If they put their hands in that cookie jar, I will call them on it. I will call them out. You think that my opponent, whom PM Prime Minister Christie says, can pick up the phone and call him, pick up the phone and call him, and you can have what you want? Wait a minute. Wait a minute. He is not there. He is trying to get there, my opponent. But the Prime Minister has some people already sitting at the table. Well, let's take a look at them. Dr. Perry Gomez, North Andres. What has he done? Well, let's take a look at Cat Island, the Deputy Prime Minister. He's the Deputy Prime Minister. What has he done for Cat Island? My brothers, my sisters, as your Member of Parliament, I will promote good laws. I will be attentive, active, and a progressive lawmaker. I will speak out on victimization of any kind. I will ensure that government protects our borders and enforce existing laws. Let's just talk about enforcing existing laws. The other day, Mr. Gibson put out there on allowed information from the National Insurance Board to be displayed all over Facebook and the internet. This is a breach of the National Insurance Act. Where is the Attorney General? Why is he not being prosecuted? People's private information. We're living in the time when people's identity can be stolen. As your Member of Parliament, I will ensure that government does not take away jobs, but create additional jobs. You see, when you fire one person and you give the job to another, that's called job replacement. It's not job creations. Don't mind the PLP giving you false statistics. As your member of parliament, I will discourage the abuse of power. I will ensure that there's fiscal responsibility. You know, the other day, I noticed that my opponent used the BTVI. From the day I was ratified, my message has been one about BTVI. The PLP can't come up with nothing of their own. Copy, 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 copy. Copycats. As your member of parliament, I will advocate for the continued training in agriculture, greenhouses, and hydroponic labs. This technology, you see, a lot of our Bahamians don't like to be in the sun a whole lot. But we have to introduce new technology for farming, and that's what we will do. We will assist farmers with accessing funding through BAIC and the Bahamas Development Bank. I will encourage the expansion of the North Abaco tourism product through the development of boutiques, hotels, fishing lodges, eco-cottages, and boat marinas. As your member of parliament, I will work along with local committees to promote and encourage domestic tourism through homecomings, cultural shows, festivals, and regattas. I am an advocate for the North Abaco Port and the Angel Fish Creek Bridge. North Abaco, we want to build an economic center in the north. You see, a lot of our constituents have to travel on a daily basis, 25, 30, 40, 50, 60 miles to and from Marsh Harbor. We're living in the 21st century, and it is the role of government to put in the basic infrastructure to provide opportunities for our people. When this port is implemented, you know what's going to happen? There are going to be many spin-offs. There are going to be needs for warehouse spaces. There are going to be need for trucking. There are going to be need for office space.